Hey, what's up guys? Jake with Legacy 4x4 here again, and today we're going back to an older project of mine, and we're going to do the paint on my 1967 Jeepster Commando. So basically the story behind the Commando, because I know it's been gone for quite a while, is I moved out to this house I'm in now, and I dropped the Commando off at a shop with the intention of getting it professionally painted, and getting a little bit of mechanical work done to it, and having somebody else just kind of do a once-over of the whole truck. Because I built it by myself, I wanted to have a second set of eyes on it, just to make sure I did everything right and everything was put together. So the shop was able to get through almost all of the mechanical work, but they weren't able to paint it, and they had it for quite a while. The reason for it is because of COVID hitting and all that kind of stuff, they had a high employee turnover, and it was really hard for them to find decent employees to work that could do something on such a custom truck as this one. So anyways, I decided, now that I'm back and I wanted my truck back, I went out there and I picked it up. So the truck still doesn't have any paint on it, but it does run. It's having a slight clutch issue, so it's not quite driving yet, but it does run. It turns on and all that kind of stuff, and it had that once over done to it, so I know that everything is good on it except for the clutch. So here in the future, I'm gonna have to fix the clutch so I can drive it, but for now, I want to get the paint out of the way and finished, because I already have the paint sitting on my shelf underneath the welding table here. So for this, what we're gonna do is we're gonna sand down a lot of that old bodywork that I did, kind of try to smooth it out as best we can, and then we're gonna throw on a coat of primer, then a coat of blue base coat paint, and then just a clear coat on top of it. It should be pretty simple. I am not a huge fan of painting, but it's kind of one of those things that you just have to do. It has to happen occasionally. Ultimately, I decided not to get this thing professionally painted, both because of the cost, and then also because when I looked at it again after not having it for a while, I realized that like this isn't even going to be remotely a show car. It's beat up. It's not quite perfect. This was the first truck I ever built myself, and I did build it inside just a two-car garage. So it is not absolutely meticulous, and so I don't want to spend the money that it would cost to get it professionally painted. So instead, I'm just going to do it myself. So for materials here, we're going to be using some Summit brand paint. I heard some pretty good things about it on some of the forums, so we're going to give that a shot on this. We've got a urethane base coat, urethane primers, and a urethane clear coat. So yeah, that's what we're going to be doing. Let's go ahead and get started. So at the end of this video, I will also give you guys a walk around of the whole truck. Once we get it fully painted, I'll just do a brief little walk around of what's been done to it, what's left to do to it, and kind of like that sort of stuff. But for now, we've got this to do. So to get started, I need to start sanding off all of the kind of mix match Bondo, smoothing out the paint, all that kind of stuff to give it a good surface for the primer to adhere to. To do this, I went to Harbor Freight and I picked up one of their surface conditioning tools. These are really similar to the ones that Eastwood sells. I don't remember these being available when I originally did this on the truck, or did all the bodywork on the truck, but I will say I just used it to do like the first initial strip and coat, and it is phenomenal. So we're gonna switch over to one of the finishing discs, and we're gonna go through the whole truck, sand it all down, try to smooth it out as best we can, accepting the fact that it's not gonna be completely perfect, but we're gonna go ahead and get started on that. So I'm gonna take you guys outside where the Commando's parked, because it doesn't fit in the shop, obviously, because the Willys is here. So we're gonna take you guys outside, we're gonna start sanding down the Commando, and then we're gonna set up for paint. So today, I don't have a whole lot of time. I'm gonna hopefully just get the sanding done, the masking and setup done, and then I'd like to get the primer coat on so that it can dry overnight, and then hopefully tomorrow we can do the base and the clear coats if we've got enough time. Anyways, let's go ahead and get moving on this project. We're gonna start with the sanding. Thank you. All right, so we got the truck all masked up. Now, granted, I obviously didn't take the whole truck apart, which would have been the right way to do this, would be to remove every single one of the accessories, all of the seats, all that kind of stuff, and then paint it so you had less chance of overspray. Now, I didn't do any of that for a couple of reasons. First off is this is gonna get new seats because the ones in here are pretty old and they're also kind of torn up from the build process because I didn't cover them when I was welding a couple times. One of them caught fire, yada, yada, yada. So I'm not that worried about that kind of stuff. I covered up the dash where all the panels and accessories are. And then any like the bed liner sections, if that gets a little bit of overspray, I'm not too concerned about that either. I can always come back through later and spray in new bed liner. And I do have to come through and like touch up some of like the roll cage paint and things like that anyways. So I'm not really worried about that getting any overspray. Also, truthfully, the body is not that big on this. So I'm really not gonna be spraying too much in those specific areas where the risk of overspray is super high on something that I really care about. Now, granted, when you do a paint job in a driveway like this and you don't take the car apart for it first, there is obviously gonna be some overspray. I'm gonna get some paint somewhere I don't want it to be. That can get cleaned up while it's still wet if it's really bad, and then obviously afterwards I can do some touch-up stuff and things like that. So for now, I'm happy enough with how we have this. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna go through and I'm gonna spray the primer on. So first off, I'm gonna go through and clean off all the dust and all that kind of stuff, and then I'm gonna come through and spray the primer on. I'll show you guys the way the primer gets mixed up and the way I set up the air guns and all that kind of stuff. Spray on the primer, and then we're gonna let that fully cure, fully dry. So we're gonna give it the rest of the day today and overnight to dry completely. We've got nice weather right now, which is why I want to really get this project done, so it's still nice enough where I can paint before it gets really cold outside. Anyways, we'll let the primer dry, come back through, and we'll hand sand most of the primer down to try to get as smooth of a finish as we can, and then after that, then we go through and do the base coat and the clear coat. All right, so we got this done, all masked up. I'm gonna do once over, and I'm gonna clean off all of the dust, and then we're gonna set up the paint gun for the primer. All right, so the way that this paint works, like a lot of your two-part type systems, is you have an activator, which is chemicals, and then you have the actual paint. And so the way that it works is you mix it for this particular paint, it's 4-to-1. So you do 4 parts of the paint and then 1 part of the activator. So when you buy a gallon of this paint and then you do 1 quart of the activators, you actually end up getting 5 gallons of usable sprayable paint. So to do it, I got some, you know, mixing cups on Amazon or whatever so that I can measure this. I've already started painting as well, so I've used about half of this gallon up to this point. So what I'm going to do for the rest of this half gallon, I'm just going to pour the rest of the activator in there into this paint, and I'm going to go set up the spray gun again, and then we're going to start to heat paint, and I'll show you guys how it's going. So far, it is going really, really well. I kind of wish I had started with this paint, truthfully, and with a better paint gun as well, because this is going on a lot better, a lot smoother than the first paint job that I ever did on the Jeep. So all that, like, some of that bad body work, I probably could have fixed earlier and probably had a better result. But I'm gonna paint this gallon on there, kind of see how, you know, kind of like check out the body work and see how it all looks, and then decide how much more like refinishing I'm gonna wanna do before I put the second gallon of primer on there. But anyways, I've only got today to do this, and I would like to get the Jeep completely painted today, so I'm gonna just keep rolling. We're gonna mix up this paint and then we're going to go spray it onto the Jeep. Let's keep going. So you obviously do wanna get this all nice and mixed up. You wanna have a nice consistency to it. If you're using a high build primer or if you're looking to get the most amount of build out of it, you do not use any kind of a reducer with this stuff. So I've got no reducer in here. It's just the primer and the activator, the rest of it. So there's about 3 quarts of paint now in here. Which should be plenty to finish doing this first coat on the Jeep so we can go back out there, do some hand sanding on it, and get it really smoothed out as best we can, and then come back in and do another coat of primer before we do the base coats. My hope is to pretty much just put a lot of paint on the truck, and hopefully if we can do a nice even coat and kind of fill in some of the gaps, a nice thick coat of paint is gonna both protect it as well as cover up some of the imperfections in the body. Again, granted, this thing's gonna have imperfections. It's not a show car, it's not a show truck by any means, and it's meant to go off-road. So it's not gonna be a perfect finish, and I'm okay with that. Ultimately, like I said, it's gonna get ran into trees, it's gonna get beat up, it's meant to be used, it's not meant to be a pretty perfect show car. That's why it's getting just a cheap $600 Summit Racing paint job. We'll be right back. So we got the Jeep all painted up. We got all of the base coat on. Now we got to just go through and do the clear coat. I'm not going to record the clear coat because it looks just like applying the base coat. I just walk around the truck for hours and then it's over. So anyways, I'm going to go ahead and do the clear coat, and then I'll come back and I'll show you guys around the truck, talk a little bit about it, and then we'll close out this video. All right, so we've got the clear coat on, we've got the blue base coat, and we've got the primer all done, all finished up, and this truck is fully painted. Now, before I show you guys around, when I get close with the camera, you are going to see that there's a lot of imperfections. There's a few spots where the paint ran, there's just bad bodywork, all that kind of stuff. This truck, like I said, was built, this is my first thing I ever built, first big thing I ever built anyways, and it was built in my garage when I still was kind of like learning how to do a lot of fabrication stuff. So this was a major build, and I didn't kind of understand everything that I understand now. So there's a lot of imperfections on this truck. I knew that going into it, I knew that coming into the paint, and this paint laid down really well, but that does not excuse or replace good bodywork, which this truck just doesn't have. So I did paint it really quickly. I'm not the best painter to begin with, so there is some runs, there's some imperfections throughout it, and I'm okay with that. And the reason I'm okay with that is because this truck is gonna get used off-road. I have every intention of using this truck as the rig that it was built to be, so it's not gonna be just a garage queen or a trailer queen or anything like that. So recognize that there's imperfections, it's gonna get more beat up on the trails and everything else, so I'm really not worried about some running paint or some of the bad bodywork. But I am really happy with how the paint turned out. That Summit Racing paint laid down really smoothly, and having a decent spray gun helps out a ton too. So if you're looking at doing a project like this, you know, I painted this thing outside of my driveway, not in any kind of cover whatsoever. So you can do it as long as you're not looking for like a showroom quality finished product. You can get there pretty close though. If you were to come through and do all the sanding and all the post-production work and all that other stuff to it, you could probably get pretty close to a decent paint job on a car just in your driveway just like this. Anyways, let me go and show you guys around the truck. So we'll start up here with the first of the runny paint, which was right here on that flat section. A lot of the runny sections are on the flat parts where it kind of ran down when I put too much paint on it on accident. But then other parts of it, like this front fender, turned out super clean. So it kind of just depends. Some of it's really nice, some of it's not so great. But like I said, overall, I'm really happy with how the paint laid down and how it all looks. And this is the kind of stuff, like, this is why I'm not worried about being showroom quality. Like, even all of the body lines on this truck don't line up perfectly because this thing was in a dozen pieces when I ended up putting it all back together. I do got to come back through and, like, repaint some of the black parts that got some overspray on them because I didn't do the best coverage job. There's a lot of runs back here right on this little overhang here. So Matt always says, you know, a 10-foot paint job, this is probably a 30-foot paint job. You know, it's good enough. You see it on the trail, you're not going to think too much about it. If you're going to sit there and nitpick it, yeah, you can nitpick it, but you can nitpick anything. I'm also a huge fan of this color. This nice, shiny, kind of shiny Pacific blue is the paint code for anybody that's curious. There it is. I'm going to wait for the paint to dry all the way, so probably tomorrow I'll come out here and take off all the maskings and all that kind of stuff. I want it to dry up some more. And then we'll start going through and doing some touch-up black work on some of the things that need to be cleaned up. There it is. 1967 Jeepster Commando. So there it was. Like I said, there's a lot of imperfections throughout it, as you guys saw as we kind of walked around. And it just kind of is what it is. It's a truck. It's going to go do truck things. It's going to get beat up. I'm okay with that. I don't have any intention of stripping all these body panels back off at any time, probably any time ever, to fix all of this bodywork and to make it look immaculate. Maybe one day, you know, years and years from now, maybe I'll come back through and rebuild this truck, but for now, I'm happy with it as the first truck I built where I got to learn a ton of stuff, all the suspension work and all the other stuff that I'd never done before, and really getting into fabrication on my own in my own shop. Anyways, so that's all finished up. Next up, we're gonna fix the mechanical issues on this truck. So to go back to what I talked about at the beginning of the video, I can't open the hood because it's painted and I don't want to touch it. But inside, what the shop was able to accomplish, they had a Holley Sniper EFI kit that somebody else was going to use and they ended up not using it. And so I was able to pick it up for a really good price. So this truck has a Holley Sniper EFI kit on it now, and it runs and it works and everything's tuned and everything does what it's supposed to do. The issue I'm having is the slave cylinder, I think, is mounted too far forward on the bell housing. And so when the slave cylinder actuates, it's not fully activating the clutch. So the truck isn't able to drive. So that's going to be the first thing I fix, because otherwise this thing's pretty close to, you know, being complete. Because it runs, if I can fix the clutch, I can start moving it around and start doing some testing on it. And then after that, there's a few small things. I'm going to get some new seats for it. I got to get a front drive shaft for it. And I want to go through and do a few other like small upgrades and add-ons and things like that, as well as a once-over. So we've got a couple more videos on this before I start wheeling it, but it's getting pretty close to getting to the point where I can start taking it out places and start testing it out on stuff. Anyways, I know paint videos aren't the most exciting, but that's what I was doing this weekend. So I hope you guys enjoyed this. Make sure to like, share, and subscribe. Let me know if you got any questions down below. I'll be happy to answer any questions you might have. Anyways, see you guys in the next one.